Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study about the informal communication. In the previous class, we have studied about the formal communication, and in today's class, we are going to study the informal communication. Informal communication refers to the interchange of information unofficially. So, this means that we have studied this just opposite of formal communication. In formal communication, we studied that it is the interchange of information in an official manner, and this is the interchange of information in an unofficially. So, not following a proper path or not having a proper we can talk to anyone, isn't it? So, such kind of relationship is called as the informal communication. This communication is based on informal relations like friendship, membership of the same club, the same place of birth, etc. So, this means people, those who are having relationship like that, so they will be making a communication. So, such type of communication, like you are having a lot amount of friends, or you may be a member of some clubs and you may be meeting together, or you may be belonging to the same village, so that is why you make friendship. So, such type of relationships are called as the informal relations, and the communication that is made between these two people, in this relation, is called as the informal communication. The exchange of informal message usually take place on the occasion of community meals, social occasions, parties, etc. So such type of occasions are there, like any common functions are there, like a birthday celebration may be there, or such kind of any celebrations will be there, any common, any marriage function may be there, or any get together will be there, or in such type of situations we will be gathering together, and the communication made in that such type of functions are called as the informal communication. Okay. So, on such occasions, the superiors gather such information from the subordinates as may be difficult to get through formal communication. Such communication includes comments, suggestions, etc. Under this communication take place through gesticulation, moving of head, smiling, and by remaining quiet. So, when you are having like formal informations are there, or formal communication is there, all the information may not be able to collect. So, a manager wants to collect information from the subordinates. So, all the information may not be, he may not be able to collect all the information. So, but at the time of informal communication, we will be able to collect the information properly. Okay, so there will be some social gathering or get together and so on will be there, and at that time they will be if they present a kind of topic, and they can easily understand the, so at that time they will be reacting in a very free manner. So if in the office when we are saying about the matter, then they may not be giving, or they may not be giving their actual reply. But at the time of informal communication, or at the time of informal get togethers, the people will be ready to share their own ideas. So, and you can also easily understand from their gestures, or the way that they are reacting to different situations. So, when we are talking about a particular topic, so we can easily understand what is the correct response of that person. So, in the office, like a formal message is there, and if anybody is disagreeing with this one, you can make a comment under that. So, such type of information will be given. So, but many of the people may not be reacting. But when you are saying this one in the informal communication, so people, even though they are not saying sometimes, but from their gestures and the actions, we can understand that they are not, whether they are interested or not interested. Okay, so such type of things you can easily understand. Okay, so for example, a superior wants to complain against his subordinate to his officer. At the same time, he is afraid of giving it in writing. This can be conveyed to the higher officers through informal communication, say during the course of a conversation. So, see, like if a superior officer wants to make a comment on the junior officer that the person is not working properly or any kind of things. But if he wants to make it a formal communication, then he has to make it writing and send it to the senior officer. But he is afraid of doing it. If people come to know, then it is not going to be a good thing. So, if he wants to say something, or like get together like that, things here or there, so at that time they will be able to talk to them freely, and the superior officers will be coming to know about it. So such a way it can be informal. Informal communication is also called a grapevine communication, because there is no definite channel of communication. Under it, some information passes through many individuals and covers a long distance, making its origin obscure. This is exactly like a grapevine, where it is difficult to find the beginning and the end. So you see, when we studied about formal communication, we saw that the source of information, from where this information is coming, exactly we can understand the source of information. But at the time of informal communication, the source we cannot understand. So like it is starting from one place and it is spreading to different channels. It is like grapevine. Grapevine, you know, the grape plant. The grape plant is known as the grapevine. So the grapevine means that it is starting, its beginning will be there. From there it will be having so many branches are there. From the branch again the branches are there. So it is going through different areas. And afterwards, we will not be able to clearly identify where it is starting and where it is ending. Okay, so such a way the informal communication also will be there. So like if in our school, imagine that if a message has been transferred from like if the class is there, one message will be spreaded in the entire campus. And if you ask to some person from where did you get the information, they may not be able to identify where it has started and where it has ended. We don't know properly, any idea will not be there. Who said it? So if you ask, then he will say that somebody has said it. And if you ask that person, he will say that some other person has said it. So such a way it will be fully mingled, and we will not be able to identify the who is the source or who from where this information has started. Okay, the starting and ending will not be able to understand. Okay, next we have to study about the features of the informal communication. Formation through social relations. So this communication is formed through the social relations, like a friendship or membership of the same club, or such type of things will be there. So based on that, the informal relationships are starting. So this based on these informal relations, and this informal communication will be done. Then two types of information through this communication, information about the work and the individual can be collected. So there are two types of information that can be collected. One is about the information related to the work, that the work whether they are satisfied with the work, and all these type of information can be collected. Another type of information that we can collect is the information about the individual. So like we have to understand about one subordinate, or what is the type of behavior, or how is his behavior, how is his character, all these things if you want to come to know, then we can easily understand this one through the informal communication. So we know that, see, like if you want to, if in our school or if in our village, if we want to find out a person, how is the character of a person or how is the behavior of a person, if you want to understand this one, we can easily understand from the informal way of communications. Then uncertain path. So as I have told you, there is a grapevine communication, and the from where it is coming and where it is growing, going, that we cannot easily identify. So that is the another feature of this one. So it is having an uncertain path. And quick relay. So this will be, information will be passing in a very fast manner. So it is like if official informations are there, then they are passing through a formal channel, and it will be very much time consuming. But at the same, at the time of this one, informal communication passes not following a proper channel, and it will be spreading very fast. So very fast way of communication will be there. Okay. So these are the features of the formal communication. Next we have to study the advantages of the formal communication. So there are some advantages of the formal communication. The first advantage is that fast and effective communication. So under this communication, the message move fast and their effect is equally great on the people. So the information is passing from one person to another, and it is spreading. See, like if one person is speaking, if I am telling one information to two persons, then those two persons will be speaking to maybe two to each. So it will be spread out to again 4 members, then after that 8 members, and then it will start multiplying like that. So it will be spread out all throughout, and the information will be passed. So you know that there are so many information coming in Facebook and WhatsApp and so on. We don't know whether the information is correct or not, and from where this is coming, who is sending this one, all these things we don't know. But also we are trusting these things, and we are forwarding the messages also. You know, so 80% of the messages that are coming in the Facebook and WhatsApp are not correct. There are no proper information. Next advantage is that there is a free environment. Okay, so the like communication, when we are speaking to someone in an informal way, like official information are there, or official communication is there. So that is a formal way of speaking is there. So there is no free, we don't feel a freeness. But when you are having an informal communication, this is a like a very relaxed way or free environment is there. Okay. And a better human relationship. So when you are having a proper relationship with the people, like informal communications are there, so our relationship is it will become better. So we will have like a friendly atmosphere is there, so we will be speaking and we will be sharing ideas about ourselves and also about others. So such a way our relationship will be becoming easier. And easy solution to the difficult problems. So there will be so much complicated problems, and the managers may be trying to solve these problems, but they may not be able to find a proper solution for this. And when they are informing it in the informal way, so different people will be giving different suggestions, and there will be easy solution for the problems that are formed. Okay. Then satisfying the social needs of the workers. So the social needs, like we know that we want to have a respect and a reputation in the society. So these social needs can be achieved very easily. So these are the advantages of the informal communication. And whenever there are advantages, there are also some kind of limitations. So now let us discuss about the few limitations of the informal communication. So this is an unsystematic communication. Though there is no proper systematic way of communication, it's not there. Okay, it is an unsystematic communication. So we don't know from where it is coming, and the language that they are using also may not be proper, or we don't know the authenticity of the message, whether this message is true or not. We may not be able to believe all these type of problems are there. Then another point is that unreliable information. So the authenticity of the messenger we cannot have. So there is no proper authenticity, or 100% we cannot trust the information, whether the information is true or not. Okay. So these are the some of the limitations of the informal communication. So there are next topic is given like a barriers to effective communication, and this topic has been cancelled by CBSE for time being. So this year you need not to study, and that is the end of this chapter. So in this chapter, the remaining portion that is given is not necessary to be studied. Okay. So thank you so much.